Hi, good morning. I am Ishani. I'm a psychotherapist and an acupuncturist, and I do a lot of other things. I use a lot of modalities to heal people or to help people or facilitating healing. And today I'm representing Heal Clinic, and for 30 minutes or so, I will be talking about today another concept and helping people with their relationships, which is called as family constellation. Now, what is family constellation? Family constellation, as it says, like how in a constellation there are many stars which are together, connected together, forming a meaningful name, is called constellation. So, family is actually made out of many stars. So, whether these, the role of each star in the family is played properly, whether their positions are taken properly, this constitute how the dynamics of the family is. Now, the family can be an organization, a school, or an event, or group of people, or actual family. It can be any of such things. It's a setup where there are more than one person involved with a type of a relationship. It's called family. So how these, the underlying dynamics of the family affects a person, and understanding that and trying to put it the order and the role properly is the method called family constellation. Now, this family constellation was it's developed by many of the psychotherapists in the world. And first, very first, it was started by a German priest who was a German priest. His name is Bert Hellinger. He was in Africa for 15 years, and during that time, he studied the Zulu families, and he figured out there is a proper place, order in the family, and there are three set of rules which actually govern the family. And if these three rules are actually followed by the family, then every member of the family will thrive in the family. When I'm talking about thriving, means financially, health, wealth, and mentally, physically, and in all aspects. If a person is happy and doing what he is meant to do, or doing what he is actually without any hindrance or restrictions, then that means he is thriving. So he figured out that maintaining the order, maintaining the role, if it has not happened for whatever reasons, what could be the reason that it is not happening, is a diagnostics method in this family constellation. Now, the three basic principles which govern this family are: one is need for belonging, that is, I am also part of this family, I am one of the family, he is one of us. It is the need for belonging. Every person in any family, it can be a organization setup also, business setup also, it can be group of people who are connected in some kind of relationship or whatever it is, there is a belongingness, and that is extremely important. And the second one is need for the social order, chronological order. When there are spouses, husband and wife, first, the partnership relationship is important, which has to be understood, taken care of. Then comes the parent relationship, if they have children. Now, if somewhere you ceases to be those partners and you are only concentrating on the parents, on being a parent, then actually the whole setup starts imbalancing. So first you have to make sure that husband and wife relationship is fine. Then actually you both should act the parent relationship with the child. So this is how some of the things are. Give me one second. Now the third thing is also as part of the need for a social order, parents are there and then comes the children, and among the children the siblings are there, the first one, the second one, the middle one and the last one. Like that, all these order have to be followed in a family for the family to thrive. The third one is need for the equilibrium. I give some and I take some. So there has to be a need of balancing. Now what happens is when this equilibrium starts, or when the role or when the order starts shaking, as a coping mechanism, people will start taking up a wrong role. People will start taking the wrong order. So then slowly the equilibrium will start shaking up. So in that moment, in that particular situation, though this coping mechanism is going to work in the long run in the family, after the generations, probably after two generations, it will become a dysfunctional family. For someone else who tried balancing in that moment would actually cause a dysfunctional family, and the members of the family won't thrive anymore. So when these three basic rules actually start imbalancing, we call that it is an entangled family. Let me give you an example of an entangled family. If there are two brothers and one of the brother is disabled, now this brother, the other brother who is actually very healthy and everything is fine with him, he cannot go tell the brother that, see, my fate is very good and I am really thriving. I have all those things which you don't have. I am blessed with good health and body. He cannot say that. He feels somewhere guilty about it. Now this guilt, if it is not addressed properly, it will be slowly transferred. The fate of that disabled brother will be transferred to the family of the brother who is actually good. So probably one of the children of the brother who is good may start having physical problems or financial problems, or he may feel that I'm never successful. He may have a very bad relationship with his spouses or with partners, and so this may continue. The only reason, because out of love and loyalty, we seem to take the fate or the problem of the family on us. Now this has to be resolved. It is like we have to understand that slowly the entanglement between the children of the brother who is good with the brother who is not well, that is disabled, the entanglement starts at the energy level in the family dynamics. So this is what is called the entanglement, and the children, that is the next generation, wouldn't understand why this is happening. Somewhere which is being handled properly at the level of those two brothers, acknowledging without the guilt that there is okay, I mean, we are born like this, will actually cause the change in the family. Now, at what point would be doing the consolation? Probably the child of this brother who is really good will come for a therapy, because he would have tried everything, done everything, but nothing seems to be working. Then when you do, what is actually happening in the dynamics of the family, these things will come out. And when this comes out to the awareness, that is from the unconscious mind to the conscious mind, when these things come, automatically the awareness will let go of this fate, and then it doesn't become fate anymore, rather it becomes a choice in your life. So I don't take that as a fate, I choose it. If I want to do it, I will do it. If I don't want to do it, I don't do it. This is how it will change. Now, What are the systemic symptoms of these entanglements? It can come in any way. It can be illness, it can be mental issues, it can be relationship patterns could have been gone, and persistent feeling of the failure and not thriving financially. All these can be the systemic symptoms of these entanglement. So now across this world, a lot of psychotherapists are using this as a diagnostic tool, or they are also using it like a full-fledged therapy where when it comes to the awareness, this can change. However you want to do it, you can use it. It's much easier than the psychotherapy. It's much easier than the counseling. And there is nothing much a therapist has to put an effort. Rather, automatically it surfaces and it makes some kind of a change in the family dynamics of this the client. Now, it is also a very quick therapy with astonishing results. I'll just share one or two case studies which I have done, which will throw some more insight on how probably the clients can understand how properly the person who's been affected can change themselves. Now, there are different methods of doing this. Usually, this requires a group setting where there are more people who can play the role play. Or you can also do with papers and puppets, or you can even do it online at a distant, from the distance. Okay, so there is something called phenomenology. So what is this? We call that as a knowing field. That is the place where the constellation will be held. This can be any place, any hall, any seminar hall, or any place you set it up. And it is basically a hall with a square place where there's no obstructions in the middle, and there's ample space for the people to move in. So this we call as a knowing field, meaning this field knows everything. It actually can pick up from the unconscious mind of the person who wants to address his or her problem, and it will show up there. So how it is done is, the person who wants to address, let me call them as clients, clients can sit on a chair and witness as an observer of their own family dynamics, the unconscious family dynamics which is contributing to the problem they are undergoing. So there will be other members, representatives is what we call. They will play the roles of the client's family. Now, either the client can explain the problem in front of everybody, or we can play it blind. That means to say, the client will actually explain the problem to the therapist or the leader who is going to hold the constellation. And the other representatives who are going to work as a role will not be told what's actually the situation. So they don't know whose role they are going to play. Now, at least some four or five people will be chosen to play the roles of the problem of the client. For example, it can the client may choose two people as his or her parents, father and mother, and some few as his siblings or uncles, or some few things as his job. So he can choose some of the roles, some of the representatives as his roles, and he will guide them to stand in his particular places which he thinks is the right place for all these people who are playing the roles, facing a particular direction. Then he will come and sit on a chair and watch his own self there. So he also has to put himself, one more representative, as himself onto the knowing field, which is nothing but a hall. Now what happens is, these representatives will be given some time to actually zoom into the roles. which they've been told. They're not even properly told that you're playing my father, you're playing my mother. They are not even told. They're just put there blindly. And they will pick up what is happening to them. They will pick up their physical feelings. They will pick up their mental feelings, emotional feelings, or any images coming up in their face, or any memory which is coming up. They will start telling. They may tell that, this is aching here, or I'm just getting angry looking at that person. So, or I feel stuck up here, or I just feel like moving there. You know, so they will tell what is happening to them physically or emotionally or anything which is coming up to their mind. Now, each person will be given a choice to say what is happening to them. And we don't have to get into too much of a story. You just have to get into knowing what is physically or emotionally, mentally is happening to them. That is all it is. And every now and then we have to confirm with the client whether it makes any sense to him or her. And all the time, it will be. Every time when I have held a consultation, they'll be, oh my God, he's exactly saying like my dad. Oh my God, that's exactly what is happening to me. Oh yeah, is that how it is? I should have looked at that this way. So it will be like a revelation. It will be like an awareness for the client watching here. His own family, his own situation, like an observer from outside. Now, once this is done, we should allow these representatives to move, to take up a different position in the family. So, why we do this? Because the order might have caused some problem in the family. The person who is probably the second one in the family would be actually thinking about as if taking the position of the first daughter or son of the family. That could be wrong. Now, when they move here to their positions, something else in the family dynamics will change, because the knowing field is the reality. Though all these people are not real, his family members, and the situation which we are going to change is also not exactly what is happening in the family, but the knowing field is the real energy of the family. So something else changed there, that means the real family will change. The person's situation will change in the family. Now, why do we always get entangled like this in a family, in any relationship? That is because out of love and loyalty. Now, if two soldiers go for war and one soldier dies, the other soldier feels extremely guilty for being alive. So he acts being dead in the family. He will be so dead that everybody feels that he is totally dead. Now he is kind of following the friend, the buddy, into his death. So when he realizes that he is doing it out of love and loyalty, that will change. So if these entanglements are not brought to awareness, these things will repeat in the family again and again, until they come to the awareness. For example, if an early death happened in the family, or somebody is disgraced, they got married to somebody and the family did not like, so they just threw him out of the family, or some loved one dying in the family, or even the abortions, or the miscarriages, all these things will carry their fate or their energy into the subsequent families. So it all depends on how the family, if the family has to actually deal with it properly. What do you mean by dealing with the family? Accepting whatever happened in the family, letting all our children know about it. There was a person like this in the family. So this will actually make the family not take from them. You know, telling like this, I know that he was a very nice uncle, but then it's his fate. It happened to him. So when we talk like that to our children, our children out of love and loyalty won't take those fate on them. Now, so what are the different kind of things which show up in this we can solve using this is mental health, physical health, anxiety, illnesses, relationship problems, relationship dynamic problems, and relationship problems with partner is a very, very common one. And also organization problems. Somehow people, the organization heads will feel that things are not working out for them. They are not able to make profits. Then you have to see which are the partners in the family, in the organization, and what is the underlying unseen dynamics between the partners, and whether they are playing their role, whether they are taking their orders. Order in the sense the first one who has paid probably highest money or age wise older, are they taking their roles properly? So when you start changing these, everything else also will change. Many times what happens in an organization is people train their employees, but will anything greatly change in the organization? Most often these employees will leave after some time, because they start realizing that out of love and loyalty of the organization, maybe it is coming because it's a good salary, maybe it is because my boss is good, or maybe it's because closer to my house, they allow me to work from home so that I can spend time with my child. All these kinds become love and loyalty, and they will stay put in that organization. But organization won't grow well. There is some definite problem in the organization. Maybe the teams will have problem. Maybe some particular project will always go down. So when you do this family constellation thing, or when you do the soft skill to the people, they will ultimately leave and go, because they don't get along anymore with the organization dynamics. Kind of they realize what is happening and they leave and go. Instead, what everybody should do is actually think about how, find out the family, the organizational underlying dynamics, and try to say change it. Try to put the order. Try to put the belongingness of one of the partners properly. When you start doing this, surprisingly, organization will start thriving. So this is one more best place to actually do the family constellation for organizations in a corporate setup. So, so business problems can be solved. Now, why this happens? Why human beings? What happens is, many of the times we pick up these love and loyalty towards even our society. Now, if two countries are in war, it will affect all the people of the country. And it continues to, so for example, the British were the colonization country earlier. Now, whatever they might have done, now the people of the British people are the most who are always apologetic. So it just becomes part of them. It is called systemic symptoms. So there is so much we even do from the society. And since human beings are social animal, it's all about surviving, each human being surviving. It is not. It is that I want my tribe to survive. It is always about the family to survive. So that is where the love and loyalty will come, and then whatever the mistake is done in the family, the other people will take it. So it is always better to balance it. You have to handle it well in that particular situation, being very objective than being subjective, and then trying to address the things won't allow us to be entangled. But even if it is happening, then somewhere probably you should just do a family constellation to see that what is happening to me. For example, one person is not at all getting married, so there could be a lot of reasons behind that. But if, let's assume, the mother of that person lost her husband when she was very young, probably the daughter also will feel that I shouldn't marry at the unconscious level. So how many ever guys she tries to be with, it never works out. So when you put back that energy of the husband, that is the father, into his play, and then acknowledge everybody, including the daughter, then the dynamics of the family will change, and the fate of the daughter will actually change. And when the daughter says to the mother that this is what happened with you, but that is your fate, I would want to move on with my life, is what they are supposed to exchange the NLP statements between them. Now, this family constellation can also be used as a very good diagnostics tool to understand what is happening, and then afterwards you can actually do your other therapies, get the other therapies done to change yourself. You can even do counseling later on. Now, this one more thing about this is we kind of do self-sabotage ourselves. So, the victim and the perpetrator have both, their generations will undergo the same fate. It is not the karma that he did, so next you will take on and you did, so they will take on. It is both of them will have to suffer. Because entanglement can happen with anyone, anybody. It is not exactly with your father, you are the vertical one. It can be diagonal, it can be horizontal with anybody in your this thing. So, and the symptoms cannot be exactly saying like, this is how it happened, so the same thing will happen to me. If that person did not get married, so I may not get married. It is not like that. The symptom can be in any area. It can be like you may have a great relationship, but your health is bad. Or you have a very healthy life, but you're financially soaring. And maybe you have everything, but you don't have any success. So all these kind of thing, if you've tried all other therapies and modalities and you've tried to solve yourself, if it doesn't work, then I think it is really good to see what is the family dynamics under these situations. One example I would like to tell, that I had one client who came because there were lots of skin issues and related to acidity. So quite a few things were happening to her, and right from her birth she was suffering from skin issues, and she had tried a lot of things were not working. She was still continuing to do it, but she just wanted to know, is there anything that she would want to know, get the awareness. So we did a family constellation for her, and what turned out, when she explained, it was nothing to do with her health related issues. What she explained was, there are four of them, siblings, and she's the eldest one. And the second one, the next to her, is a brother who's gone out of the house because of various fights between him and the parents. And now the parents are talking to him, he's talking to the family through her. Why through her? Because she's the first one. And he is repeatedly taking money from the parents. Now, so she's been, she was undergoing a lot of stress because a lot of things she didn't want to do it for her. You know, she didn't want her parents to get affected. But at the same time, she wanted the brother back. And she felt somewhere that she's been abused by the brother. So this was going on and on and on, which finally actually showed up in her body. But what was that she had right from the birth? That did not explain. So we set up her family. I set up her father, mother, herself, her brother who's gone out of the family, and two other siblings who are after that brother. And then I also set up another element which is called diseases, because there are many diseases she was facing. This is all with her. It was her. I asked her what she wants to choose, and this is how we came up. We always do what exactly the client wants to know. Then we started figuring out, we felt that there is another element which needs to be introduced. And when we introduced that, she immediately realized she had an elder brother who died as a baby. So we introduced that. And she started realizing that that elder brother is actually angry, because the first position is taken up by her, and she is not rightfully the first child. So the feeling, if the brother would have been there, it is like as if, how can you do this? And the acidity seemed to be coming because of that. So out of love and loyalty, she would have manifested that as acidity, something burning in her stomach all the time. Okay? So it is like he's burning with that anger and jealousy, that how can she do that? She's just because she's alive, like that. So that, and the moment she felt that I am not the first one, I am nobody to take this family problem, why should I take all this? Why should I be between the brother and the parents? If they have to solve it, I should not be taking it, because anyway I am not the first one. All the time I thought I am the first one and I was taking it. So that is one revelation. Another revelation she got is, I am keeping all this issues, everything, it's making me crippled. So then suddenly she realized that there was uncle, mother's brother, who was actually disabled. I'm not very sure, mentally or physically disabled, but she was very close to him and he died 8 years back, and she was little guilty that she is living and he had to die and go because he was disabled. So that was one of the issues she was, you know, punishing herself, that I mean, how can we can live when he couldn't live a better life. So that is another thing which came out there. So then we brought the brother, we brought the uncle, and we made the entire family stand in their proper order and position, and we made her tell that she will rightfully take the second position and it is not her right to solve any of the problems which has been faced. Whereas the second brother, he was doing like, I did not get love of the family, so I will take the money of the family. So that is how he was taking it. So when the client told that you are also part of the family, we all actually siblings and you should take your right position so that the parents love you, automatically there was a sigh of relief in her, you know, when the order is maintained. And once the consolation is done, at least you will have to wait for a week time for the client to realize, rewire in their head, and so the dynamics can slowly change. And it's very recent case, I have not discussed with her how things are going with her, but I'm sure somewhere something will change for her. This is how the constellation work. Now, I'm very happy to share with all of you about this family constellation. And if any one of you think that you need to discover something more about what's happening in your life related to your family, or it can be anything, you can even use this family constellation to find out whether, if you have three jobs in your hand, which job to take. So you can figure out how it is to be with each job, what is your relationship with each job, and you choose the right job. Or if there is something happening with your love life, what do you want to figure it out about it? So it can be practically used with anything. So all of you, if you're interested in learning this family constellation also, you can get in touch. Or if you want to have an experience and figure out your family problems or any problems or business problems, organization problems, please get in touch with Heal Clinic. We can set up these sessions and do for you. Thanks a lot for watching, and goodbye and have a good day.